In some situations, the eigenvalues of a matrix are easy to find. So one of these examples is for triangular matrices. Now, let's recall a theorem that we already know. So we already know that the determinant of a triangular matrix is the product of the entries on its main diagonal. So in other words, if we let matrix A be an n by n triangular matrix, then the determinant of matrix A is equal to the product of the entries A sub 1, 1 times A sub 2, 2, all the way up to A sub n, n. So we can now go ahead and apply this theorem for triangular matrices to what we know about eigenvalues. So if A is a triangular matrix, then so is the matrix A minus lambda times the identity matrix. And from our triangular matrix theorem, this also says that the determinant of matrix A minus lambda times the identity is just a product of the diagonal entries. So this implies that the characteristic equation of this triangular matrix is defined as A sub 1, 1 minus lambda times A sub 2, 2 minus lambda, all the way up to A sub n, n minus lambda is equal to 0. Now, from this characteristic equation, it immediately follows that the eigenvalues are defined as lambda sub 1 equals A sub 1, 1, that lambda sub 2 equals A sub 2, 2, and we continue merrily along until we reach lambda sub n equals A sub n, n. So we can now go ahead and summarize our observations here with the following theorem. So this theorem says that the eigenvalues of a triangular matrix are the entries along the main diagonal. So we can really appreciate that if we have a triangular matrix, this is going to provide us with a nice shortcut. And this theorem applies to both upper and lower triangular matrices. So let's go ahead now and illustrate this theorem with an example.